really is weird, y'all. It like gooped up. Like I said, I think it was old. Okay, so I'm gonna come under the eyes and get not only the I'm gonna come actually out here. I'm not only going to get just the circles, I am going to get the whole area around the eye. People call it the triangle. And I'm going down the side of my nose just so you see. And coming right around that little hook and into this little area right here that you want to disappear. And I will come down the center of the nose. And get out here. And right here. I'm also going to do this. It's just not a norm for me. I usually do this all this with powder, y'all. So I am literally using this product. Actually, I'm going to come all the way down. I know some of you are like, Beth, oh my gosh. Okay, is that all I want to do? I think it is. So now what? Now we'll use the highlighter in a minute, but that's after you've blended and everything. So now I'm going to use her little sponge product. And I'm going to get right in the crooks of my eye and come down by the nose. Right in the crooks of my eye, that little socket, and come down by the nose. Purposely let my white hit the edges of my nose. And I'm also going to do this. I'm going to use my finger a little bit because I don't want to get I'm purposely making almost like a little splash out. That's how I'm doing this. By the way, I like this product. This little sponge applicator. I'm getting in the crease, the wrinkles, if you will, real well. And now I'm going to go all the way out and all the way back, all the way out, and just blend outward. This brightens up behind the eyes, which again is something you want to do. Get this little wrinkle right there. And then get down right here. Get that real good. There's a lot of pores there. Now what I would say is the way I'm doing this, you'd have a lot of blending to do, but I'm okay with it. I'm okay with that. And down. Okay, now this is not base, so this isn't probably the way to do this, but it's just what I wanted to try. Okay. Okay. Now I'm going to blend this. What this does when you put white back here is it gives a facelift. I think a lot of the young girls are calling it baking, but what it basically does is just give you a facelift under that contour, so it rises that area up. Remember, light brings things forward. Oops. There you go. Here's one thing I'll say for the concealer. It's doing a great job of concealing, y'all. It's concealing my age spots. Look at that. Now I know I look very bright and white, but I'm not finished. It really did. It did a great job of coverage, age spots. Okay, so that is myself with contour and blending. Now I'm going to add, I know it's very bright, that's okay. It's okay. Don't freak out. Okay, so we're going to use this highlighter under the brow. We're going to use it over the Cupid's bow. Tip of the nose, right down the bridge up here in the tip. Sometimes people do this, I'll do it. I don't know if I want to do it here or not. Maybe a little right there. I don't want to go up too high because when you do and you're older, it highlights the wrinkles. Do you want to do that? Right? So I'm just going to blend that in. Now let me just tell you, if you weren't so pale as me and you had like a tan and used the darker one of these, I don't think you'd have to do anything more. I think you'd have been done. But I'm so pale, even using the concealer, the way that I did, looks very, Okay, so now I'm gonna bring this forward a little. The light is very light, but then I'm very pale. I'm beginning to think maybe I'm not. Maybe I'm a little more, than I thought I was. A little more, medium. I think as you get older, that just happens. But anyway, so there is the final contour. And, so there's four colors. I don't know where I am in all this. That's the final contour and highlight look. Now, I'm not finished by any means doing my makeup, so don't freak out. I'm going to choose the darkest of these lip glosses. This is Kimmy. So you can see that one. Plenty of people have done swatches of this, so I'm not going to. This is Kiki. It's a little paler. This is Kim, which is very pale. And then it goes to like almost like a nude beige, and that's Kimberly. All right, so how do these products feel? Feels like glass, frosted glass, which is very, very pretty. This is beautiful packaging, I think. Beautiful, very classy, I think. It sticks with the kind of Kylie thing with the dripping because you're so hot. definitely not my color. Or, I don't know. Maybe I'll go with a warm look. This is very peach. Not what I would have picked. But, because I never, ever do, we're going to go with a warm look today. Yeah, that was very, very peachy. And, looks like it's the darkest of all the colors. Okay. So, to go with this look, I am going to use this Too Faced palette. It is the Peanut Butter and Honey. Peanut Butter Honey. So, let's open it. Very cute. It's the metal packaging. And it turns this way instead of this way for a change. And these are the colors inside, which are definitely going to go with the look that I have today. See that? I'm going to pull back a little because I think it's actually easier to focus when I pull back. Okay. So rather than talk it, I'm just going to begin. I wonder how well this stays on this lip gloss. Does it dry? We're going to see. Right now. Okay. So, sorry. First of all, I need to do a little blushing and calm down all this bright white. So here we go. I'm going to use my VH Cosmetics palette from with Carly Bible. And I am going to use maybe a little more bronzy color. How about that? Mix a little pink, mix a little bronze. That and then I also wanted to do I need an actual blush. There, to the end, that will work. There we go. Gonna calm things down a little bit. That's so bright white. I'm just adding a little powder to that cream. definitely a different look for Betsy. Hey, gotta try new things. I don't know if I do this every day, but okay. So here is a little book to tell you how to do things. This palette is the Bee's Knees. That's neat. What I like is that it does have a mirror. Okay, so on my eyes, we are going to do a nice, we've already done a highlight, so I'm going to do right below the highlight in this color Peanut Butter. It is a more peachy tone, which is what we're going with today. There we go. As you can see, it's the true color of Peanut Butter. I must say, with this primer, I probably should have used that concealer. You can see my veins. It just really popped them. Sorry. I get so busy that I forget that I'm showing you something. And so we're just kind of going up and down and then blending back and forth. Blending toward the eye, not away. There we go. Okay. Very peanut butter indeed. Alright, so now I'm going to use the darker color. I'll use the Bee's Knees. It's kind of like a, it's more of a, it's this one right here in the middle. It's more, it's got more of glitter to it. We'll see if it actually does. Okay. There we go. Yes, it's like a bittersweet color. I'm going to keep that in the crease though. I'm going to circle it up and bring it in. Saving the lid for another color. Now, this is a completely different look for me. It's extremely warm. It's rusts, it's browns, it's peaches. Not even browns, it's just peaches.